Hello, in this video we are going to discuss doubly or bidirectional linked list and its insertion operation. Now, the prerequisite of this video is a singly linked list, or in general the linked list and the insertion and deletion operations and mechanisms of linked list. In doubly linked list, just like as a revision of the basic concept of the linked list, the linked list is a linear data structure where each node is connected to the other node, some other node. Now, in the linked list, the linked nodes, the adjacent linked nodes, may not be the adjacent in memory, physical memory, may not be in the adjacent locations in the physical memory. For example, suppose this is a linked list, doubly linked list, and this is basically a linked list where we have the addresses, like the first node is in the address 110, the second node may be in the address of 200, the third node may be in the address of 50, the fourth node may be in the address of address 140. So those are the different addresses. The addresses are not ordered as per the memory locations are concerned, not ordered, or not adjacent or contiguous locations are represented here in the linked list. 110 is the address linked with the memory location 200. So these two are the linked, adjacent linked nodes. But in physical memory, those two are not adjacent. There are huge gaps. So now what happens? In doubly linked list, in singly linked list, we have found only one part is there, info, which carries the data, which contains the data element, and the next part is the pointer that points to the next connected node. Actually, that contains the address of the next connected node. But here, in case of doubly linked list, we have three parts: previous, info, next. The info part stores the data or the content or the data element. The previous is the pointer that points to the previous node in the connected list. And the next part is next pointer that points to the next node of the list, next connected node of the list. Actually, its pointer stores the address of the next element, and previous stores the address of the previous element and points to the previous element, it points to the next element. So this is a doubly or bidirectional linked list. Now what happens? We are going to discuss the insertion operation into it. So now, inserting any node at the beginning of the list, the first and the simplest algorithm of insertion is inserting any node at the beginning of the list. As we know, in case of linked list, the head is a pointer. The linked list starts with the head pointer. The head is a pointer that points to the first element of the linked list or first node of the linked list. Actually, the head pointer carries the address of the first node of the linked list. The head contains the address of the first node of the linked list, and by this it points to the first node of the linked list. So if I going to insert an element, if we are going to insert an element at the beginning of the linked list, then we must insert it between the head and the currently first node. The new node we are going to insert is also having the same structure: previous, info, next. The same structure is followed here. The previous part is a pointer, should contain the address of the previous connected node. The next part is a pointer, next pointer, that contains the address of the next node. And the info part contains the value, the data, the element, the content. So now, the new node, if going to insert it in the first location of the linked list, beginning of the linked list, there are two cases. First, the linked list can be empty, and another case, the linked list is not empty. In case the linked list is empty, there is nothing here in the list. For example, suppose, so we don't have head to be connected with any node. Head is not connected to any node because the list is empty, the first case. In that case, what will happen? Our new node, what we are going to insert, the new node the previous, the head will just point to the new node. And moreover, the next part of the new node, that is the first node of the list, should be null. It will point to none. It will point to no node. It will contain no address. So the value of next will be null. The next will store no address, nothing, null. And the previous will also be null because it is going to be the first and foremost node of the linked list. First node. And the head will be connected to it. So the simplest one. So when the linked list is empty, originally empty, we are going to insert a new node. Here the address of new node, we can call it as PTR. The address of PTR, the new node we are going to insert, should be stored in the head. Should be stored by the head pointer. So that the head pointer can point to the new node. That is PTR. And the previous pointer contains null, means no address, because there is nothing previous to the first node we are going to insert. The list is empty and we are going to insert the first node. So previous should contain the null. And next should also contain the null because list is empty. There is nothing in the list. This will be the first and last, both. This node is going to be the first node as well as the last node. So we can represent it if head equal to null. This is a condition that represents the empty list. The empty list. We are going to insert a node at the beginning of the list. There are two subcases for that. Subcase 1, the list is empty. Subcase 2, the list is not empty. If head equal to null, then what will happen? PTR, next, the next part of PTR, the PTR pointing to next, will be assigned by null. PTR info, the previous part will be assigned by null. Previous part will be assigned by null. And the PTR will be, the PTR means the address of the new node, the PTR, address of the new node, PTR will be assigned to head. Assigned to head. So that the head will point to this first newly inserted node, PTR. That's why to do so, we have to assign the address of PTR into head. Now this is the simplest way. Else means if it is not empty, if the list is not empty. What will happen in this case if the list is not empty? What exactly will happen in this case if the list is not empty? Now if the list is not empty means the head is connected to some node. This node, suppose. The head is connected to this node and there are elements in the list. And the new node we are going to insert. So what to do? Firstly, we have to connect this next part. We have to connect this next part of the newly inserted node with the currently first node. The next should connect to the, so that it will become the next of the newly inserted node. So that it will be the first step of making it the first node and making it a second node. Now what will happen else? The PTR next, the next part of PTR will be assigned by the address which head is carrying currently. The head is carrying currently the address of this node. The address of this node. So, currently what head is holding, that thing, the PTR's next pointer should hold. The next pointer of the PTR should hold. Okay, so PTR next will be assigned by the content of head. So far, the head was carrying some address, that is 110. That 110 will no longer be carried by head. It should be carried by the newly inserted node, that is PTR. Now still head is carrying. We have linked to this. Okay. This is single directional link we have made. Single link. From PTR to the first element. Currently first element. Now what will happen? Head will point to this, head previous, means head is pointing to this first node. The previous of the node head is pointing, we have to write in this way, the head hit arrow previous, that means the previous part of the node the head is pointing to. So that is written by head arrow previous, means the previous part of the node head is currently pointing to. Okay, should contain the address of PTR. Should contain the address of PTR. So what will happen? This previous part should contain the address of this PTR. So bidirectional link is established between the new node and the currently first node. Now this link we don't need. We don't need this link, because this link will be, so long as this link will exist, this will remain the first node. We don't want this to be the first node. Henceforth we want this node to be the first node. So we have to have our head to be pointed to this newly inserted node PTR, instead of pointing to the currently first node. So the PTR will be assigned to, the address of PTR will be assigned to head. Address of PTR should be assigned to head. So now this link is, this is delinked, and this link is established. So now head is pointing to PTR. PTR is pointing to the node which was so far, which used to be the first node, and whichever was the first node so far, is the previous part is pointing to this PTR. So PTR is actually has become the first node, and this currently first node, the so far which was the first node, has become the second node. So this is the way we can insert NDIF. And then one more thing required, that's very important, that is inserting the item to be entered, not only creating the node at the beginning, inserting the node at the beginning, but also what we have to do, we have to insert the value into it, the item, the content into it. So what will happen? The PTR info, the info part of the PTR will contain the item entered by the user. PTR info will contain the item that will be entered by the user. So this is how, this is the algorithm of how a new node can be inserted at the beginning of the doubly linked list or bidirectional linked list. Now, this is the beginning location. Now, how to insert a node? What is the algorithm of inserting a node at the end of the linked list? How to do it? For this, we have to introduce a new pointer called temp. Temp pointer, which is assigned by the address of head. Temp is initialized by the head. Head's address means it is actually starting from the head pointer. The starting point is where head is there, existing. So this point, it will start from the temp pointer because it is initialized by the address of head. Now while temp is a pointer, will hold the same structure of each node of a list. So temp is a pointer that will hold the same structure of each node of the list. Okay. So the structure is previous, info, next. So while, so long as, while means so long as, so long as the next part of temp, the next portion of temp is not equal to null, not equal to null, this operation will go. Whatever we write will continue. That is, temp will be equal to assigned by temp next. So every time gradually, the temp will increase, the temp will go into the next location. Next, next means the next part of, suppose temp is this, the first node, this is temp, the address of this new node, that is temp, first node, that is temp. Now temp's next, storing the address of the next one. So temp pointer will be updated by the next address, means temp pointer's address will now be 110. So now again, temp, next part of it is not null. So again this operation will be performed. Now new temp will be old temp's next. The old temp's next will carry the address 200. So the value of temp will be updated to 200. In this way, the value of temp gradually will proceed. It will update it from 200 to 50, 50 to 140, and so on. And how long it will go on, how long it will proceed, how long it will go forward, till the next part of it becomes null. This means it till it reaches the last note, till tens becomes the last note, till tens becomes the last note, it will proceed one by one, next, end by. After that, the tenth reaches the last position. Temp has become the last note. Temp represents the last note at the end of this loop. So after that, what will happen? The temp next. So our PTR is the new note we are going to insert. PTR is the new note we are going to insert. So what will happen? What should I write? The temp's next, the next part of temp. Okay, that will be assigned by the PTR. So PTR will be assigned. PTR is the PTR, suppose the next part of next should point to PTR, that is also having previous info next, these three parts. The next part of temp next, the next part of temp, the next pointer of temp should be assigned by address of PTR, this is the PTR. The new node we are going to insert at the end. So, we will assign by PTR. Now, PTR's previous pointer should contain the address of temp. Temp what is currently last node, so far last node. So, previous of PTR should contain the address of temp. Now this. Next is having the address of PTR, the previous pointer is storing the address of temp. And the next pointer of this PTR, which is the last node now, should be null. So PTR next will be null. And the info part will store the item entered by the user. So PTR info, this info will have the item to be entered by the user, like this. PTR info will be storing the item to be entered by the user. So PTR info is assigned by item. So this is the algorithm for inserting a new node at the end of the list. This is the algorithm for inserting a new node at the beginning of the linked list, and this is the algorithm to insert a new node at the end of the linked list. Now, as a revision, basic revision, we have the 110 in our example, 110, 250, so on. Now this next part, what is previous? This is suppose 30, the address is 30. In this case, the previous pointer stores the address of the previous connected node, that is 30. So the value of the previous is 30. The previous pointer carries the address 30. Now next pointer stores the address 200 because it points to the node existing in the 200 location of the memory. Memory is 200 location. The previous pointer carries the address 110. The next pointer carries the address 50. Similarly, previous pointer carries the address 200. Next pointer carries the address 140. In this way, it goes on. In this way, it is connected. So, I think the point is quite clear that how to insert a node at the beginning, at the end of the linked list. Now we have to show how an element can be inserted at specified location of a linked list. Specified location of a linked list. Now see. Suppose the location number we are going to insert to be entered by the user in the variable loc. It will be stored in the variable loc, LOC. And the item that user is going to be inserted is stored in the item variable. These two variables we require. Now, the same thing, the 10 pointer is assigned by the address of head, is initialized by the head's address. So it will start from the position of head. Now, for I equal to 0 to location minus 1, since the counting starts from 0, so I will start from 0 to location minus 1 every time temp will be assigned by temp next. End for. Now location, suppose in the third location, 1, 2, 3, third location we are going to insert an element. Means in between the second and currently third. In between these two we are going to insert an element. So LOC is 3. So the pointer, the counter, the loop counter starts from 0 to loc minus 1 means 2. 0, 1, 2. It will go from 0, 1, 2. So in this way, it will just move. So it is going to be inserted at some location, LOC means, suppose third location. So it will go from 0, 1, 2. Now what will happen? The location, the temp will be the address of the particular element in that location where we are going to insert the new element. So now, suppose we are going to insert the new element in the specified location. So what will happen? The next of temp, the next what temp, suppose this location is pointing, this is the location, this is the location minus 1. So temp will carry the address of this, after which the element is to be inserted. Because location will be 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. I starts from 0, the temp equal to head. When I is 1 temp here, when I is 2 temp is here. We are going to insert the element here, somewhere between second and third. The third location, between second and third. So LOC minus 1. So here, what will happen? Now temp is this one. What temp next is pointing at? This particular. Now we are going to insert the new node between temp and between these two. Between these two. Next. So what to do? Temp next will be assigned by the pointer. Temp next pointer will be assigned by PTR. First, we can say, or we can say, the PTR next, anything you can do, PTR next, the next of PTR will be assigned by what is currently assigned by the next of the LOC. This is temp. Next of the temp is pointing to this node. Next of the temp is carrying the address of this node. Now, the PTR will contain the address of this node. PTR's next part will contain the address of this node. So PTR next will contain the address what so far is being carried by temp next. Temp next. So temp next is carrying the address of this. Now PTR should carry the address of this. PTR should carry the address of this. Not only that. The temp next, now the temp next will be assigned by PTR. So we don't want this link. So temp next, the next part of this temp, this is temp now, after the loop is terminated. This is now the temp. So next part of temp will carry the address of this. The next part of temp will carry the address of this. Single directional link is established. And what we have? The next part is pointing to this PTR and the PTRs is pointing to the next part, PTR next equal to temp next, and also the PTR previous is containing, or the temp next is containing PTR, temp next is containing PTR. PTR next is containing the currently temp next, means this address. And temp next is containing the address bit here. So this link is not there now. Now what happens? The temp next, okay. The temp next is this one. Whose previous should be? The previous of PTR should contain the PTR previous before that should contain the temp. The PTR previous should contain the temp. The PTR previous of PTR should contain the address of temp. So this link is also established. Now, this temp next, what PTR's next is pointing to? PTR's next is pointing to, so PTR next is pointing to the previous of that should contain the address of PTR. So temp next. So suppose temp 1 equal to temp next. And temp 1 represents this node. Previous part of this node should carry temp 1 dot prev dot previous should carry the address of PTR. Should carry the address of PTR. Again, temp starts with head. Temp starts with head. I starts with 0. So when I is 1, temp has become this. Suppose location is 3. We are going to insert an element in the third location. First, second and third means in between these two. We are going to insert. So I starts from 0 and temp starts with head. When I becomes 1, temp will proceed by one step. When temp equal to 0, it comes here. I equal to 0. When I equal to 0, it starts with the loop. Temp will come in here. Will be coming here. When I equal to 1, it comes here. Okay. So long as I becomes 2, so it will just come up to this point. So in between these two, this and this node, we are going to insert the next node. So after the end of the loop, we are having here. Here we are moving here. So PTR next equal to temp next, temp next equal to PTR, PTR's previous will be temp, temp 1 should be temp next, and temp 1 dot previous assigned by PTR. Temp 1 dot previous, temp 1 dot previous will be assigned by PTR. So this link is also done, not is vanished, and this link is established. So it's complete insertion, total insertion is made between the second and third location. Okay. So this is the algorithm what we have for inserting any element at the specified location of the linked list. Inserting a node at a specified position of the linked list, and not only inserting a node, but also we have to insert the item in the node. So PTR info will be having the item entered by the user. PTR info equal to item. So we have run a loop, we have executed a loop. I started from 0 to LOC minus 1. Suppose LOC is the location we are going to insert the element. After, suppose location is 2, if I assume, for example, 1, 2, so after the 2th location, the thing will be inserted. When I equal to 0, the temp starts with head, I starts with 0, and temp goes forward, temp becomes, temp will carry the address of this, temp comes here, temp represents this node. After that, I becomes 1, temp is this. Okay, location is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. So after 2th position, so after 1th position, so now this, after that we have to insert this one. So now these operations are done accordingly. The question is to insert a node after LOC position. The position number is LOC. after 12th location means third location. After 12th, this means 1th, 12th. After this, we are going to insert the new node. LOC is 2. This means it will be 0 to 1. The loop will be from 0 to 1. When the I is 0, tape will be coming here. When I is 1, tape will proceed here. So tape will be this. After execution of this loop is over, the temp will be this. Temp will be representing this node. So what will happen? PTR's next will be, the next pointer of PTR will carry the address what temp's next was carrying so far. Temp's next was carrying the address of this. Now PTR next will carry this address. And temp's next, the next part of the temp, the next part of the temp will carry the address of PTR. So this link is also established. Single directional links. Now bidirectional. PTR previous of PTR. The PTR's previous should carry the address of temp. And temp 1 will be one step. It will proceed one step. Temp 1 will be assigned by temp next. The next of this current, the last temp. This is temp 1. Temp 1 dot previous, the previous of temp 1 should carry the address of PTR. So this is the way, this is the algorithm to insert a node at the specified position of the linked list. Thank you so much for hearing. Now we'll discuss the deletion of nodes from linked list from various locations in the next video. Thank you.